I'd like to thank my wife for being here tonight. Most of you know that she had a little accident, and she's here, hard-headed and all, but and this is a song that she gave to me to sing a little while back, and this is the first time I've ever sang it, so just pray for me and pray with me and help me a little bit. Not just about the manger where the baby lay, not all about the angels sang for him that day, not just about the shepherds or the bright shining star, not all about the wild men traveled from afar. It's about the cross, about Sunday, about how Jesus came to be born once so that we could be born again, about the stone that broke the way so that you and I could be someday. It's about the cross, it's about not just about the present underneath the tree, not all about the feelings that season brings to me, not just coming home to be with the ones you love, not all about the beauty and so I'm dreaming of, about the cross, about my sin, about how Jesus came to be born once so we could be born again, about the stone that was rolled away so that you and I could have your life someday. It's about the cross, the beginning of the story is wonderful and great, but it's the ending that can save you, why we celebrate. About the cross, about my sin, about how Jesus came to be born once so we could be born again, about God's Son, free. It's about how every drop of blood that flowed from him when it should have been me, about the stone that rolled away so that you and I could have real life someday, so that you and I could have real life someday. It's about the It's about the
stairway, and the creatures gather round, and didn't make a sound. And the angels cried.
The angels knew what was to come, the reason God had sent his son from up above. It filled their hearts with joy to see, but knowing of his destiny came tears of love. And the creatures gathered round and didn't make a sound. And the angels cried.
And I often thought about that night and wondered if they realized the stars so bright
was sent to tell of a land the Son of God would soon become the Son of Man.
And the creatures gathered round and didn't make a sound. And the angels cried. And the angels cried. And the angels cried.
The call of a shepherd in a field nearby to tend and to carry his flocks by night. They were not ordinary sheep, they were set apart, born to be Passover lambs. And when a spotless male was born, he was held on the manger floor, swaddled up just to keep him calm until his time. And the shepherds say, wrap this one up, he is the Lamb without blemish. Wrap this one up, he'll make his way to the temple, born for sacrifice. He'll join the others and pay the price. Wrap this one up, wrap this one up. Oh, the call of a mother in a town nearby, tend and to carry on this holy night. Not an ordinary child, but the Son of God, breathed by the Holy Spirit. On the manger floor, as she swaddled him up, she knew his time would come. And as she sang, wrap this one up, he is the one. He'll wear the crown forevermore. He's come for you and me. He'll finally set us free. Wrap this one up, wrap this one up. He's the
Oh,
your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand. Did you know?
We celebrate you. We're so
how thankful we are for all of your love. So Jesus was born, wore a crown of thorns, gave it all up just to save us.
Circle of love.
Each one who participated through the ministry of music tonight. I just want to share thoughts with you from God's Word. Scriptures from the book of Micah, chapter 5, verse 2. But thou, Bethlehem, Ephratah, though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall he come forth unto me that is to be the ruler in Israel, whose going forth hath been from of old, from everlasting to everlasting. Several hundred years before the birth of Christ, it was prophesied that Jesus Christ would be born in Bethlehem. Today, we as our family had our Christmas time together. I know you have your plans, you have your time, and to each his own. As the children and the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren were wading through their gifts, I think it took about 10 minutes for them to undo everything that had taken several months to buy and wrap. And they're wading through the paper, even as they were enjoying their gifts and their Christmas. I thought, as I have in the last weeks and days, Christmas as the time we were children, how different it was. When we would get a brown paper bag with a few pieces of candy, perhaps an orange, and maybe a pair of brown cotton gloves. And that was a good year, if we got that. We so depended on the gift bag, which basically was candy and fruit that the church gave every year. This church did that when I first came here. And the reason we discontinued it was because children had so much that they really didn't understand or appreciate that gesture any longer. And so you think back to the time when Christmas was much different and when the little things meant so much more. We often talk about, if I were God, this is how I would do things. Well, we're not God. And as someone had said, if we were God, we would do it exactly like he did it. And the reason we don't think so is because we're not God, and his thoughts are not our thoughts, and his ways are not our ways. God was never big on big. God always did things in a way that puzzled the average person. The birth of Jesus Christ proves that. for several reasons. First of all, the place where Jesus Christ was born, Bethlehem. If God ever wanted to make a statement, he could have picked and should have picked any other city, any other town but Bethlehem. Of all the places, and the scripture bears that out, though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, any place God could have chosen but Bethlehem would have made a statement and an impression on people. And to the contrary, he chose the little town of Bethlehem. And when you look at that town and the terrain of Bethlehem, it basically looks like a saddle. It is a town between two peaks. And nobody, at least no earthly man, would have ever chosen that town for the Christ child to have that experience of birth. Not only the town of Bethlehem, but the shepherds that were involved and included in the birth of Jesus Christ. They were, of their day, the lowest of the low. They were considered absolute nobodies. Nobody wanted to associate with them. Nobody wanted anything to do with them except God. And only God would have chosen the shepherds to be involved in the birth of the Christ child. And so the stage was already set. You see, when Jesus Christ came to earth, he wasn't big on big. He never really got overexcited about big crowds. We do. I mean, we're big on numbers. And the interesting thing is, every time Jesus Christ got a crowd together, and it happened quite often, he thinned them out. And the way he did that was by talking about taking up your cross and following me. And he said that over the hill they went. And he separated the pretenders from the possessors. And so when you look at the birth of Jesus Christ today, I want you to understand he has already set the example. If you want to come to Jesus Christ, if you want to invite him into your heart, if you want him as your Savior, you're going to have a humble beginning. You're going to have to acknowledge that there's something missing in your life. You're going to have to admit that nothing else you have ever tried has been successful. You are going to have to realize that Jesus meant exactly what he said when he said, I have come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. You have to understand what he meant when he said, for the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. It is for each and every person to possess the greatest gift that has ever been given. And as you well know, gifts are given in the interest of love, but it is up to the recipient to make sure that they are received in that same spirit. And so God today has given us, he loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And so I'm telling you tonight, God has given you the greatest gift you'll ever have. And you'll receive that gift when you come to him in humility and in honesty, and just saying, Lord, I want you to be a part of my life. I made this statement Sunday. I make it every year, if I remember to. It is the statement that I hope you'll take with you tonight. If Jesus Christ were born in Bethlehem 1,000 times, and not once in your own heart, you will be eternally lost. Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem. Jesus Christ died on a cross. Jesus Christ was buried in a tomb. Jesus Christ was resurrected. Jesus Christ ascended to be with the Father. And Jesus Christ is coming back one day to gather his children and take us home. And if you put your faith and trust in him, you'll be in that number. No matter how many times Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem. Now, by the way, it didn't take 1,000 times. It only took once. It didn't take 1,000 deaths on the cross. It only took one. It didn't take 1,000 resurrection. It took only one. And it won't take 1,000 second comings of Jesus Christ. There's only going to be one. And it's each and every person's responsibility to be ready. Say, Pastor, that sounds more like an Easter message than it does a Christmas message. I'm here tonight to tell you, you cannot separate the two. It's all a part of the same story. And that story is still being written. And it's not going to be complete until we see our Savior face to face. Tonight, as we light this candle, we're making a statement to the world. And maybe equally as important, we're making a statement to ourselves. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. He said that. Then he said, you're the light of the world. Well, which is it? It's both. We only become the light of the world as Jesus Christ becomes the light of our life. Let your light so shine before your men that they may see your good works, but it doesn't end there, and glorify your Father which is in heaven. It's not about us. It's about Jesus Christ. And tonight, as you light this candle, you are making a statement that is important to you as well as it is to everybody else. Whatever happens this coming year, and only God knows what's going to happen this coming year, whatever happens this coming year, Jesus Christ is still the light of the world. And he is still the light of our life. He is our hope. He is our peace. And he is our joy. And tonight, I pray that you are experiencing all of the above, because one day you invited Christ to come into your heart. And it wasn't just the birth in Bethlehem. It was the day that you were born again through your faith in Jesus Christ. We're going to ask our ushers to come forward, and we're asking, if you do not have a candle, please lift your hand, because we want to be sure that you are able to take part in our service tonight, if you would. you stand, please? Father, we thank you tonight for the fact that Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem. But we thank you, Lord, also that he has been born in our hearts. He lives in us. He walks with us. He talks with us. He encourages. He strengthens. He comforts and he guides. So many things, whatever the need, he is equal to it. Thank you tonight that we can celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ and know that he is real because he lives in us. Thank you that we can be the light of the world because Jesus Christ is the light of our life. May we be encouraged in our daily walk this year in knowing that he is our Savior. Thank you for every blessing in Jesus' loving name. Amen. I would ask Carol to join me at the front door here, and I would ask if at all possible if you would exit this way. We want to have the opportunity to share a personal word with you, and I just want you to know how much we appreciate you, your ministry here as we share together, and if you're visiting, to know that you have a special place in our hearts. God bless you. Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem. And all of God's people said, amen.
Amen. Amen.